We just got into Nuanetsi here. We're just a little ways from camp. Very excited to be here. This is my 7th trip to Africa, and really hoping for a leopard and a few other good things here, a big croc, but we'll see how it goes. How could you ask for any more? So nice here.
On any leopard hunt, the first call or first job is to go collect bait, and luck would have it on our side. We find a group of impala rams, put Ken on the sticks, and one shot, two impala drop, so we're off to a flyer. Well, Ken, I've had guys shoot a couple of impala, but never first off in a safari.
Hey, right off the start, you know, get two baits with one shot, that's pretty good.
Yeah. I know it wasn't intentional, but no. It certainly helps with the baiting anyway.
Yeah, I was aiming forward as far as I could, but he was just too close behind him.
Yeah, luckily with impala, it's one of those things you do get pass-throughs, but we're needing a lot of bait.
Yeah.
And if you keep that up,
it's a good start. It's a dang good start.
We're going to end up with lots of bait quickly. So yeah. Good shooting, sir.
Thank you. Well done. Thank you.
This is a bait site I took over from the previous leopard hunt. I was ideally wanting spotted hyenas here, and the guy said there's a lot of hyenas here. So I took it over on my last hunt too. Try to shoot spotted hyenas, and Murphy's Law, the day I took it over, the spotted hyenas left. So it's a very good area for leopard. Thanks, Dougie. And yeah, on the second last day of that hunt, a female leopard started feeding here. So I kept the bait going for spotted hyena, and the female leopard's been around. But the guys have found a track today. It looks like a young male, so yeah, we're gonna put up a fresh impala, hang a little bit higher, so if a male leopard does come, he's gonna have enough food, and maybe drop that one a little bit for the spotted hyena.
Might be a little young and stuff, but well, that'll mean another one won't come in too. So we'll up another bait there and see what happens. Eat some. We can put out the bait for the leopard and let them eat, so we'll eat too.
Through that gap there. Can you see him?
I got him.
Okay. Right. If you're happy to take him, take him. Yeah.
Yeah, we got a bunch of brush. His head, I can probably pop him right through the brush.
If you want to try. Yeah, that worked.
even in the down.
Mm-hmm.
And there's just a little brush in front of him, just leaves and stuff, it wasn't much.
Okay. Yeah, you hit him, so that's good. He then took off that way.
Day two, we're gonna go out and shoot some more baits, hang some baits, and see what goes on. Maybe we'll also get some nice big game animal that I wanna get. So we'll go out and see what happens.
Well, we were racing to the south to look for zebra, and conveniently there was a very big rock put in the road, and right where we were removing the rock, the guys found some big leopard tracks. It's heading down the road we've just come from, but the water point isn't too far. So one of the spots we'll probably come back to and put a bait sometime. We're just in bait collecting mode. Once we finish with that mode, we'll be in bait hanging mode and we'll be back here. So yeah, put in the memory bank and come back later. Well, it's been a total contrast of mornings. Yesterday started off with a whirl and a bang, and today it's been hard going. We haven't actually seen much, but I think it's mostly due to this wind. It's been blowing quite strong and steadily the whole morning, so.
Pretty strong, yes.
We've managed to find an impala. Ken made a great shot, put him down on the spot, and we've got our first bait for the day, so.
Adding
we're on the board.
Adding to it.
You're looking at us, isn't it? Is it right in the chest?
Yeah.
Zebra, they hit him good. It's facing right at us, so I got him in the chest, so we'll see. We got another bullet in here.
Well, things happen quickly, huh? We're just driving around, actually heading towards our one bait. Came around the corner and the three zebra there. So. Jumped out the car, Ken put in a good shot, and I'm busy trying to find the tracks to track it now. Not very good. Yep.
Got up.
Well done, sir. Good shooting.
Went right through the boiler room. Just a little bit of death run, that's all.
Well, Ken, that's Africa for you. You don't know what's gonna happen. It's been an awfully slow day for us.
Then all of a sudden everything happened.
Yep, I mean, we stopped, had lunch, driving to go check our baits, and yeah, next minute there's three zebras standing. We jump out the car. I whistled for them. They luckily came back to it, which is quite unusual in itself. But
so they came to attention, all looking right at us.
You made a great shot. He didn't run very far, and we've got a very nice zebra stallion, beautiful skin.
Yeah, pretty animal.
But more importantly, we've got four good leopard baits
that's
for him.
Right. So that's the most important part of it, absolutely.
Good shooting, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Well done.
All right.
Unbelievable. I never thought I'd see any wild dogs here. Unbelievable what they do. They sort of chewed the bait up. Not much left as far as they can reach up. It's pretty well gone. We're going to set up a bait here. Mark has said there's been some male leopard tracks. They've been seeing them on and off for quite a while coming up and down this road. So, and there's water not far away, so we figure this is a good place to set up a bait. That's what we're gonna do.
Well, this is an old dam wall that we're actually standing in at the moment. It burst years ago. There's quite a bit of water up top there. I used to bait right close to the water, and that's some fair success, but never actually shot a cat there. I know there's a big cat here. We've seen his tracks often. The bait site I've chosen's got a lot of nice shade there, so the bait won't rot too quickly. It's got a lot of cover for the cat to approach. We've then got this sandy creek bottom here, and then my blind's going to be on the other side, so it should create a sort of a safe zone for the leopard that we on the other side of the creek. Yeah, trail camera set, bait set, just got to wait for the leopard to make its move.
I think we're building blind about 8,243 right now. I'm not sure, probably not quite that many, but we've been putting a lot of baits up right now and yesterday and today, and let's see if we can get a leopard hit on one of them. Clearing a path and stuff, so we no deflection of a bullet if we shoot. Seems like he's probably gonna be on the ground if we shoot one, so make sure there's no brush in the way. It's no fun. It's all work when you're hunting leopard or lion. And of course, this is a leopard hunt, but we shot baits, we hung baits, we ran. And the baits are not close together. They're long distance apart. And so it was, you know, 5 hours a day at least was spent running the baits, baiting up, adding baits if they were being eaten on, shooting baits, running out of baits and scrambling to get a couple more to get them up. We wound up with 12 baits, the active baits out there. And just day in, day out, it was one day after the next. We got a little bit of hunting in between, but most of it was, you know, making sure our baits were getting plenty of meat on them and checking them and seeing if anything had hit them.
I seen a pollen and a bolt hole in a tree. I guess it went through and went through into the tree here. Another one down, another bait. just keep getting them and hanging them. Hope we get some leopard to come so we don't have to keep shooting all this bait, but we'll do what we have to do.
What did you see? What have you seen, Ken?
Kudu. I don't know. I didn't get to see the top, but we saw it. And we'll go after it and see what happens.
Well, we're driving down the road and we spotted a kudu bull that looked pretty nice. So we decided to give chase to it. It turns out there's actually two bulls. Back one was the better of the two, which I never got a good look at, but we're busy tracking him. And Tinus suddenly saw this civet.
You see the civet, yeah?
Sort of
it's alive. Take him if you want him.
And the kudu walked right past us. I pointed him out, and Ken
point blank
wanted to shoot it, so we shot it, and we got a very unusual trophy on a kudu stalk. So.
Well, Ken, it's been quite a morning so far.
Yeah. Been good so far.
It has. It's terrible weather. Very windy, overcast, quite cool. But the game's certainly been out. And Africa threw another curveball at us. And
that's for sure.
Next minute, Artina spotted the civet hunker down. Presumed just trying to keep warm. I pointed it out to you. It actually looked dead, but I could see his eyes looking at us.
Being so close, I thought he was dead or something was wrong because, what was he, 4 or 5 yards?
Yeah, something like that. But yeah, I think he was just trying to rely on his camouflage and us right. Just walking past him. Right. So, very unique and unusual trophy, especially to take during the day. So, good shooting.
Thank you.
Well done.